covered some of the serious violations found by state inspectors at local restaurants. Tonight, two popular Des Moines eateries are speaking out about issues found in their kitchens.
And what steps workers have taken to ensure compliance. Patrick Bell joins us with their story.
Yeah, Stacey and Kevin, while some restaurant employees believe these violations are trivial, others say inspections are crucial to keeping their business safe for you and your family. But perhaps the most important facet of tonight's story is what you can do to make sure your favorite place isn't serving up problems.
Centro is perhaps the busiest restaurant in downtown Des Moines.
But with popularity,
we open to immediate success and great reaction from the community.
Comes scrutiny.
All you can do is take it as a positive learning step and move forward.
In December, a routine state inspection revealed several critical violations at Centro. Problems with the holding temperature of some fish and vegetables, a few unclean contact surfaces, and an employee observed mixing a container of salt and pepper with fingers.
We had 99% of those changes fixed and addressed before the auditor even left.
Marketing Director Chris Diebel is right. The report does indicate most of the issues were corrected on site.
We were very proactive. Nobody should be concerned because we put out a great product, and the return visit from the inspector certainly reflects those sentiments.
Just down the street on Court Avenue.
When you do hear food, hear restaurant, hear critical health inspection issues,
yeah,
people are going to immediately think the worst.
Inspectors cited Johnny's Hall of Fame Cafe for 8 critical violations and 6 non-critical items.
One of our freezers, I don't think we had a thermometer in there, which I don't know where that went. Our frozen bacon and eggs in a crate, in a box, were on the second bottom shelf versus the bottom shelf, which the state requests or requires. I think of our violations, I wouldn't classify any of them as critical, but some of them fairly minor.
And that's a common complaint from those whose restaurants were cited.
They're tedious sometimes, but they're required. The FDA food code says this is what we require, and there's a reason why that they put those rules into place.
State investigators say those critical violations must be taken care of before diners are in danger. But some restaurant owners say, come on, some of these problems are petty, like being cited because frozen corn was stored an eighth of an inch below regulations. Is that trouble or just trivial? You decide.
It's a great reminder on the little things.
Right.
So I would say more than anything, they probably need to look at maybe some of the terminology.
Sometimes you just need an extra pair of eyes, and you take it positively, and you move forward and integrate those findings.
We have a criteria here where we exceed everyone's expectations.
Steve Sarcone's Army Post Road Dairy Queen is one of the few restaurants with no violations whatsoever.
It takes a good effort to get it done.
Workers and Sarcone himself typically stay well past closing time, scrubbing countertops, sweeping floors, and disinfecting machines.
Once the machines get shut off and we get security and we get everything locked down, we start with all the dishes to the back room. We get all the counters wiped down, everything cleaned up. My motto is always, a clean store is a good store.
And there are others. Inspectors gave high marks to the Barnes & Noble Cafe on Jordan Creek Parkway, Casey's Kitchen at Mills Civic and I-35, the Civic Center second floor eatery. Long John Silver's on Fleur Drive in Stanton was praised for good housekeeping. At local schools, Dowling Catholic was recognized for cleanliness. And at work, Iowa Farm Bureau's cafe stood out for its lack of violations.
So you might be wondering, how can I check my family's favorite place, or what about the restaurants at which I've eaten for years? Well, it's actually very easy. The state's Department of Inspections and Appeals has a database in which you can check every restaurant, school, or cafe in Iowa. Reports are posted online. Just click on one of them to read what the inspector found. And we've made it simple for you to find as well. Just go to kcci.com and click on featured links. It's just another way that you can make sure what's happening in that kitchen or any kitchen out there is up to your standards.
Very interesting.
Absolutely.
Patrick, thank you.
You're welcome.